Hi, I am Dr. Sridhar Kalyanasundaram. Welcome to my channel. In the previous video, we had discussed about lactose intolerance, and in this video, we will discuss about cow's milk protein intolerance and how these features may overlap. So, if you have not already subscribed, please do subscribe. Turn on the notification so you get intimated when you get new videos. And please do share with your colleagues as well. So we discussed that lactose intolerance is intolerance to the sugar in the milk, whether it is breast milk or the formula or cow's milk. Most of the infant formulas have lactose as the main sugar as well in the stage one milk, and then the proportion changes as the stage of the milk progresses and sucrose or the normal sugar gets introduced. Milk protein intolerance is a totally different entity. That is a kind of allergy that develops to the milk protein. Allergy normally develops to protein component. We get exposed to a foreign protein. If we don't recognize it as self and we start developing an allergic response to it, some people have a tendency to allergy. It can be atopy. You may manifest as eczema, you may manifest as allergy in different parts of the body like nasal congestion, hay fever, asthma and food allergy. So we call it an allergic march when it starts with eczema and then you manifest with food allergy in the next few months to a year or so. And then you start developing the respiratory allergy like hay fever and further on to asthma. So allergic march is a spectrum of these allergic conditions. So allergy is basically a predisposition. You have a tendency to react with an allergic reaction. We all have heard of the hygiene hypothesis, where being not exposed to many of these organisms like normal common cells or the bacteria in the environment leads us to develop a tendency to allergic reaction. So the body immune system has components which favor a development of a protective response, a fighting response, versus that favors an allergic response. So if your immune system is not exposed to various bacteria in the early stages of life, if there is too much hygiene, so to speak, so much stress on hygiene, we may have a tendency to develop allergy. And some of it is inherited as well, as some families would vouch that they have different family members who have tendency to allergy. So food allergy is one such allergy, and when we develop allergy to a protein component in either the milk, the egg, the fish, or even components like cereals and rice, for example, we call it food allergy. Milk allergy is one of the commonest allergies, and here the allergy happens to a protein component in the cow's milk. In most cases, as we consume cow's milk allergy is common. We should remember here an interesting fact that milk allergy to cow's milk protein can happen even in exclusively breastfeeding babies through the protein component being transferred from the breast milk to the baby. So when the mother ingests cow's milk products, the protein is present in her bloodstream and that can pass on to the baby. The protein doesn't need to be a huge protein. It can be a broken down part, a peptide chain to which you may react as well. So the component to which you develop allergy is different in different people. And that's why your responsiveness to treatments may differ as well. Lactose intolerance manifests as bloating, distension, excessive colic, nappy rash, which is difficult to treat, and so on. However, cow's milk protein allergy presents with different manifestations. It's quite varied in presentation, so it's difficult to pinpoint exactly how the child presents. So it may just be a colicky baby who doesn't settle down, a baby who keeps demanding feeds all the time. Mother may think baby is hungry, but actually it's a discomfort that the baby is crying from. Baby may have mucus and repeated loose stools. There may be blood in the stools, which is one of the clear-cut markers that indicates that there may be allergy. A baby who is normal for 2-3 months suddenly starts getting blood spotting in the stools, it may be one of the components that the mother is taking. If it is an exclusively breastfed baby, if it is a formula fed baby, they may have been sensitized to the formula milk over time and then they start developing allergy. So this is another important factor, that sensitization might happen anytime. So you don't need to react with an allergic reaction in the immediate phase when you take the food product for the first time. You may be sensitized and then the allergy may develop with time. So as I said, mucus and loose stools, blood in the stools, failure to thrive. It's an extreme feature where the babies don't gain weight adequately. They're irritable all the time. They're miserable. They don't gain weight well. So this is a marker as well. If you're thinking of milk protein allergy, but it's a late manifestation. Many babies do not have this failure to thrive because they come to attention because of excessive crying. Vomiting can be a feature as well, and you may have reflux, which is persisting. So features of reflux, milk spitting up, the baby being uncomfortable, griping all the time. So these are also indications that milk allergy may be a component. The diagnostic tests are varied. Skin test for milk allergy is not essential. The radioallergosorbent RAS tests on the blood are non-specific. Sometimes you get a positive result, and many times clinically we may decide to treat even if the baby doesn't have positive signs. A stool test for lactose, for example, reducing sugar in the stool, may not be conclusive, and lactose intolerance diagnosis doesn't rule out milk protein allergy coexisting. So if you think of lactose intolerance and the baby doesn't improve, we start thinking of milk allergy overlapping as well. If the mother is on exclusive breastfeed, the baby is on exclusive breastfeeding, we try to eliminate milk protein from the mother's diet totally, and this would mean not taking any milk products for coffee, tea, cheese, yogurt, other dairy containing food, ghee, for example. So you should look into the components of any foods you eat and try to remove milk containing proteins. Even small ingestion sometimes brings it back up again. So it takes 10 to 14 days after the elimination starts for the baby to settle down. So you may need some symptomatic treatment in the initial phases. And once the symptom relief comes in, if you are exposed accidentally to another milk containing product, they may react. If the response to milk elimination alone is not enough, we start looking at elimination of egg, for example, which might help improve the situation as well. So the further elimination, wider elimination is not routinely recommended unless you have a strong reason to think, for example, fish allergy may be there, so you start eliminating fish in the diet. So if you eliminate too many things, a mother's nutrition might suffer. One thing to stress here is if the mother is eliminating dairy products, she has to take calcium supplements, because in the postpartum period she is at high risk for calcium deficiency. So if she is not giving exclusive breastfeeding, the milk that we give for formula component is a special milk meant for milk allergy. The so-called hypoallergenic milk in the UAE market is different from the hypoallergenic milks in the US market, where they label the extensively hydrolyzed milks as hypoallergenic. But in the UAE market, it's the partially hydrolyzed milks which are labeled as hypoallergenic. These are not treatments for cow's milk protein intolerance. So we have to go for extensively hydrolyzed milk products. For example, Elicare from Similac is an example. We have Alernova from Novalac. We have Aptamil Pepti from the Aptamil group. So we have different extensively hydrolyzed milks. If they don't respond to extensively hydrolyzed milk, or it's a severe allergy and you want to go for the best treatment available, you have to go for an amino acid formula. I mentioned Elicare as extensively hydrolyzed. It's actually an amino acid formula. And we also have Neocate, which is well established as a good treatment for milk protein allergy. We have rice-based formulae, where these the milk is exactly similar like the infant formula, but the protein component of it is produced from rice, hydrolyzed rice. So in UAE market, we get something called Blemil HR. The hydrolyzed rice has been shown as an alternative, which is cheaper, and also it's tolerated well by most of these babies. So if you want less expensive option, because they're extensively hydrolyzed and especially the amino acid milks are very expensive, a tin may range from 120-130 dirhams in UAE to 200 dirhams for the amino acid formula. The hydrolyzed rice formula is a cheaper alternative. Obviously it's industry grade, so the toxicity, the arsenic toxicity risk from rice should be reduced, and it's hopefully going to be an option in babies where their affordability is less. But however, the extensively hydrolyzed milks are the first choice, and some of them come with a thickener, because reflux is an associated feature. The thickener might help as well. The other important aspect of management is monitoring the growth and development of these babies. Reintroduction of the allergenic component should not be rushed. I mean, if there is a definite allergy, we wait for at least 6 months to a year after the allergy is symptom free, and then we consider it test dose. If there was a severe reaction, like anaphylaxis we call it, where there is swelling of the airways, breathing difficulty, or even circulatory problems, then we should be extremely careful. Testing should be done in the hospital environment under the supervision of an allergy specialist. This is an immediate type of allergic reaction, so this is more serious. However, in majority of the situations, it's a milder form of food protein intolerance. So these babies may get some component of the protein introduced in a small dose, and then if they tolerate it, you progress. So some babies tolerate it from 8 months to 1 year of age. Some babies start tolerating it after 18 months, and sometimes it takes longer. So this is different. So this is just to give you an overview of cow's milk protein intolerance. We have expert sessions on the topic earlier with Dr. Ajmal as well, and I would recommend that you go through those as well. I hope this is helpful. Do share with your friends. Thank you.